You Don't Know Jack. We'll be right back after these messages.
Antifreeze. Don't drink that.
Why?
Because it'll kill you.
Oh.
This message brought to you by the United States Department of Condescending Paternalism.
I don't care.
I've been number one, so I might as well have numbers one slot.
Exactly.
Okay, we've got four players.
Moving on with the next one. Moving on up.
We're going in 30 seconds.
No, we don't need more. But we would like to know our name.
Yep, I'd like to know a name.
I see you two were too busy to type in your name.
Yeah.
How's about I call you Frank and Beans?
Frank and Beans?
10 seconds.
Well, just be careful not to zip up your Frank and Beans.
Yeah.
Six. Frank and Beans. Frank and Beans.
And now let us hear our quote of the day.
Hey, Cookie here. Yep. I've got a reality show for you. My dad yelled horrible things at me as a child. There's your reality show. Four evenly matched competitors.
No.
Compared to our last two recordings,
this is making the game more interesting.
So the long answer of the
you guys need to get smarter, I guess.
Bloodco. All your blood needs without the mess and fuss.
Hey, look, that's perfect for vampires.
Any gender. Bloodco. Okay, let's not waste any more time.
What the Baka? Fine, will be Baka again?
Rolling.
Yeah, that's we're not sure.
Can't we all just get along, John?
What the?
What do donut labels, Dunkin' Donuts, and Krispy Kreme have in common? Onomatopoeia, alliteration, assonance, or illusion?
A lot of
God damn it! I got it wrong!
Onomatopoeia!
No! I'll tell you guys once it's done.
Just a layer two.
Yeah, I know.
Alliteration!
Is that one?
Oh, yeah, damn. Four.
Bam! That's wrong. Players one and three. Alliteration is the repetition of the first sounds in words. And both Dunkin, Donuts, and Krispy Kreme have that.
Oh, God.
That sounds like a rapper.
So you see, they're not so good for that.
Donuts, Krispy Kreme.
Tomorrow morning, I'm going to eat a Dunkin' Donut and a Krispy Kreme at the same time and poop them out later in one unified poop of compassion and understanding.
Bah.
Let's try Space, the Final Front Ear.
What?
If Star Trek's Mr. Spock decides to have his ears vulcanized, what will be true about them? Layer three, who gets your screw? Oh, who's screwed, player one? You got 5 seconds. You know what they say about big ears? It's the wrong answer. Superb screwing, player three. Grab a few more bucks, why don't you?
Why am I singing along with this?
Because you can. That is why.
Good point.
Player three, any last words? Too late.
Oh, I took my time.
The choice you have made is highly illogical. Player four.
Okay.
Vulcanization is the process where rubber is converted to stronger, more durable materials. So Mr. Spock's pointy ears would become stronger. Which would be great because then it would be easier for Scotty to use them to open his beer bottles. And now, Bibla Blah Blah. What biblical album title would be appropriate for a Kesha album featuring different versions of her song, Blah, Blah, Blah? Pillar of Salt. Player
3,
5 seconds to pick an answer.
It's obvious!
The Tower of Babel is a story in the book of Genesis where God confused the language of all humans so they could no longer understand each other.
Like I said, obvious.
I don't consider myself a Christian.
Kesha's talking about.
Yeah,
so there you go.
One, you're the one who got screwed.
I'm still lower. In other words, I swallow your and reflect it back.
Undead
at you.
Anatomy.
What?
Which of these movie monsters is truly heartless? The Mummy, Dracula, Frankenstein's monster, or the Wolfman?
shit!
Yeah! Damn it!
I already know.
Wrong answer! Because I forgot.
I know what an answer I should have picked.
I'll let you guys have fun with this.
Players 1 and 2? I think you need to tighten the bolts in your necks. Smart people choose this. A mummy's organs are removed and placed in jars during mummification, so the mummy would not have a heart.
That's it. We're stopping the game. We're switching names.
Yeah, this was it.
Then what is that red stuff shooting out of his chest?
I forgot about that. I saw that and I knew it.
Damn it!
I should have to log in.
Blood Co. We have blood.
Why I knew it as soon as I was like, freaking hell. I should have grabbed it.
This game is catching an extra 4,000 smackers. Congratulations.
You guys did this, and then you don't even clock in with any hands.
Like
it has a wrong answer today, too.
I forgot about the wrong answer of the day, too. I believe I'm getting this.
Yeah. The score could use a hand. Why don't you play this one? I'll read off 7 phrases. For each one, tell me if it's a feature of the Nexus
are you gonna
One
be
phone,
Jaws again, Eisen?
A feature of Nexus Shampoo, or both. If it's about the Nexus phone, press left.
Yeah, this is the one or both.
If it's about Nexus Shampoo, press right on your plus control pad. If it's both, or we could just get started. Anti-breaking, digital compass, volume compass, tested on animals.
Despite your fast speed, I actually got a steal.
Yeah!
All this
what?
Talk
bull!
Of and shampoo.
Oh, well. I'm still failing, though, so there's no recovering.
I'm worse than you.
There's not a lot of room. Oh, yeah, by barely.
I still have
my screen. Mind, all the prizes are doubled.
Yeah, I do too.
Can we just
okay, then, here we go.
No!
I think the game says otherwise.
Open wide for Where the Banshees Live, and they do live well. How tall is the tallest stone at Stonehenge? Two. You got it, player 1. Player 3, you're getting screwed. You got 5 seconds. That reminds me of my favorite Joss Stone song, in that I don't know any Joss Stone songs, and you don't know the answer to this question.
Meh.
Superlative screen player 4. Grab a few more bucks, why don't you? Player 4. Player 2. 5 stone Phillips is high. The man's 6'2". Are you trying to scare every living man, woman, and child to death with this 30-foot news magazine anchor monstrosity?
Yes, I am. Yes, I am.
That was going to be my second guess.
6 feet tall. The tallest stone at Stonehenge is about 24 feet tall. So you could stack 4 Oliver Stones on top of each other to reach that height.
So
the only difference between Stonehenge and 4 Oliver Stones on top of each other is I'd be upset if Stonehenge fell over.
The sad thing is Stonehenge is sinking into the ground more.
I'd like to return this maid a milking, please. If you had to individually wrap all the items from the song The 12 Days of Christmas, how many packages would you end up with? 12, 42, 78, or 144?
Oh, wait, I did my math wrong!
Players 1, 2, and 3? I see what you did there. 12 times 12. And here's your lump of coal.
Fail.
Player 4?
Yeah, it's 78, isn't it?
1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 plus 6 plus 7 plus 8 plus 9 plus 10 plus 11 plus 12
equals 78.
78 individually wrapped gifts. You might want to invest in a large mallet, too. The allures of leaping are a lot easier to wrap when they're unconscious.
So, in other words, you want to play a game of whack-a-mole?
It's a merry-eight.
Yeah.
Why not try? Who sort of said this, more or less? It's time for a who said it question. Now, Chad, our production assistant, will hand me a piece of paper with a famous quote and...
Wait, you need that now?
Yeah. Didn't get the email?
I told you, man, for business-related stuff, you gotta message me on Facebook.
So you don't have the quote?
No.
No.
But I remember it, I think. Well, let me take a stab at it.
Okay. Who said... Chad?
If you poke my eye out, then, I poke out yours... Then the whole world isn't gonna see anything that well, I guess.
Abraham. Hi, player 2, let me get this. You just got screwed, player 4-5.
Oh, wait, I found the quote. An eye for an eye makes the whole world blind. And that was said by Mahatma Gandhi.
Because I know I'm getting nowhere.
That's pretty right on. I think I'm gonna start following this
guy. That's pretty obvious.
Thanks for your help, Chad. Player 2, that is your screw,
basically,
wasn't it?
The non-violence guy is gonna say if I... Well, Baca's not winning.
I was losing to begin with.
A barrel of donkeys.
Kong!
Which element of the classic arcade game Donkey Kong does not represent a simple machine?
Wait, really?
The barrels, the slanted girder ramps, Jumpman's hammer, or Donkey Kong's elevators?
It's obvious, guys!
Haven't you ever heard of a pulley? Well, apparently you're not as intelligent as an 8-bit ape.
Well, fuck you!
Oh, it was the barrels.
Inclined planes, the hammer is a lever, and the elevators are pulleys. But Donkey Kong's barrel stack just sits there, and it's not any kind of simple machine.
Fuck you!
What's in those barrels? I'm guessing thousands of
princess
torsos.
You have no right to say that. You got it wrong, too.
Yeah. It does make sense, actually, if you think about it.
Yeah, it does.
Coming up next, in bed. This is the part of the game where I start to feel like I need a snack. Maybe I'll have a fortune cookie.
Isn't it hilarious that you would mention something like that about a week ago?
You have an unusually magnetic personality. Well, if I'm so freaking magnetic, who's most attracted to me? Iron Man, Goldmember, the Tin Man, or the Silver Surfer? Player 2? What a pity. Players 1 and 4? Oil can! Player 3? Magnets barely attract gold or silver, and mostly no with tin, but they sure do love iron.
Yeah. Well, if he was really made of iron, that
magnetic,
is.
The last place I should be is near all this expensive electronic
That's
equipment.
The only issue. His armor is not made of iron. He made it out of gold.
No.
Yeah, gold plating and everything else. The gold would stop most of
with that. Let's just move on to our check.
Here's your clue. Yeah, you spooked me all night long. I'm bringing Spooky back. Good luck.
Yeah? What?
Yes, Chica Marley for Scrooge.
Yeah.
Cool!
I let him grab it. I think we missed it. Ha ha! Thank God. Simba.
No, damn it!
Who's pressing this?
Save!
Two!
What the
fucking hell? There, I better get
them.
We all
for slimy. Damn. That's what.
I imagine I have a good score with this. I have no good score.
This is gonna hurt.
Oh, got it!
You actually made it.
Did you aspire to win with a negative score? Was that something you were shooting for? Did you start your day saying, gee, I hope I can do something really underwhelming and embarrassing?
You did let everyone down. You got a negative for you.
Maybe tomorrow you should tell yourself.
You've made us say goodbye. And you have said a lie.
You did.
You're Rick Rolling.
You.
Hey,
you guys are the negative tens of thousands. And right
now we got. I'm 60. Why don't you keep saying that when you've actually reached positive scores?
There's a positive score. That's place way.
Having a party.
But then
just one.
Come to Blood Co. We don't ask questions. Need lamb? We probably have it. We don't really keep track of that.
My score.
Blood Co. We got. Blood.
69.
Why do you know where it came from? Blood Co. When you need blood, you gotta
69.
Blood Co.
Don't give me yourself.
But, yeah. I suppose you could say he's scoring himself. That's terrible.
Yes, it was.
Are we done, Eisen, or are we done?
I think, this will be it. I gotta get home soon anyway. And I have to make stuff by Walmart.
And now a message from the office of Edgar J. Penrod.
This has been
I'm attorney Edgar J. Penrod.
Silver FedEx.
Have you recently been in an auto accident? Have you suffered major injuries? If you answered yes to both of these questions, then
as a Rickroll that got negative score, my dear.
Hey,
saying farewell.
You don't know Jack. We'll be right back after these messages.
Funding Deutsche Feldenkommt.
Uber Nostrum.
It's delicious.
Uber Nostrum tastes just like candy.
I mean, it's tasty.
I enjoy the freedom of Uber Nostrum.
It takes the pain away.
Uber Nostrum.
Uber Nostrum makes me feel fresh.
Uber Nostrum improved my golf game.
I made $20,000.
I never knew love, and then I tried Uber Nostrum.
Uber Nostrum.
I haven't cried in weeks, I think.
You should take Uber Nostrum, just in case.
There's no downside.
It looks great. I look great.
I feel great now.
I feel good.
Good.
Goodness.
Savory goodness.
Uber Nostrum.
This is going to sound strange, but I feel like more like a woman.
I feel more like a woman.
Uber Nostrum changes lives.
Thank you, Uber Nostrum.
Thank God for
Uber Nostrum.
Du musst mehr gut gefühlen mit
Uber Nostrum.